Welcome to Lukman IAS. Today we'll discuss some important aspects of geography optional subject. That is, what is a geography optional subject, what is involved in that, and what is the syllabus of geography optional subject, and who can opt it. Okay. So, in layman's language, we'll try to understand what is a geography as an optional subject. So, let me tell you that everything around us is geography. Now, you may wonder how it can happen. So, if you are living in a city, suppose you are living in a city, then if you look outside, there is urbanization, there is movement of vehicles, there is road connectivity, there is infrastructure, and then there is slums around the cities developed. So, all these things are included in your geography. At the same time, you may have heard about urban floods, right? In Bombay or in Mumbai or in Chennai, there were urban floods in previous years, right? So, such kind of things are included in geography. If you are living in coastal city, suppose you are living in Mumbai, then you may have heard about it is a port location, right? So, there will be international trade, and there will be some kind of fishing activities going on there, or there will be some moderating effect of sea on the weather and climate of that area, right? So, there will not be any extremities of temperature in that region. So, all these things are basically, if you observe, are included in the geography subject. If you are living in the hill, let's say hill station, so hill station are generally cooler than the ground level, let's say places. So, why it is cooler? Because of lapse rate, as we move up in the altitude or let's say height, there will be decrease in temperature, or there will be mountain and let's say valley breezes in the hilly region. All these things, if you observe, are included in geography. So, these are basically let's say in layman terms. So, you may wonder, ye geography hai kya? नहीं है, राइट? सो व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ ज्योग्राफी, राइट? तो वो थ्री इडियट्स में जैसे प्रोफेसर बोलते हैं, ये लिखोगे एग्जाम में? नहीं ना. सो इन सिंपल टर्म्स, व्हाट इज ज्योग्राफी? ज्योग्राफी इज नथिंग बट द स्टडी ऑफ प्लेसेस एंड द इंटरेक्शन ऑफ मैन विथ नेचर और इट्स सराउंडिंग, राइट? इन सिंपल टर्म्स डेफिनेशन यू कैन राइट इट, राइट? सो बेसिकली ज्योग्राफी सीक्स टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई थिंग्स आर फाउंड एट पर्टिकुलर प्लेस, how they are developed at particular place, and how they change over the time, over the period of time. Let me tell you one example. We know that there are mountains around the world. Humne school mein padha hai, right? There is Himalayas, and then there are Alps, there are Rockies mountains, there are Andes mountains, right? So, why these mountains are found at that particular place only? How they are built up in the geological history or timeline of earth surface, and how they are changed over the period of time. So, basically geography seeks to understand this. Okay. So, what are the different branches, or let's say parts of geography? One is physical geography, second is human geography, and third we can say that it is environment geography. So, briefly I will tell you what is included here. Geomorphology, that is study of landforms. Climatology, that is study of weather and climate. And then there is oceanography, obviously the name suggests that study of oceans. Biogeography, here we are going to study let's say forest, animals and plants, and the biomes, or we can say that social forestry, agroforestry, all these things are included in these chapters or physical geography. The complete syllabus is divided in these three. In human geography, basically we try to understand how human interacts with nature and how nature influences human being. Here basically we have the branches in human geography as economic geography, like what are the resources available to human being, what are the industries present there, agriculture, type of agriculture, or service sector, or infrastructure, road connectivity, telecommunication, everything is covered here. Second, you can have here settlement geography, types of rural settlements, types of urban settlements, all these things are covered here in settlement geography. Or demographic geography. Here, demographic attributes like population, population density, sex ratio, all these things are covered in demographic. Or we also have here cultural geography. In cultural, we have caste, races, and their distribution over the world. Or here, next we can have here the political geography. In political geography, very interesting here, the aspects like the location of India or Indian Peninsula in the Indian Ocean region, or geopolitics of Indian Ocean region, India and its neighbors. So all these things are covered in these aspects. Okay, human geography. And here in environment geography, we have relationship between environment and man. So like ecology, ecosystem, or let's say what is the environment pollution problem, or what is environment degradation, all these things are included in that. So this is the brief overview of your syllabus in layman's language. The detailed syllabus is provided by UPSC itself, so we'll not go into that part. Just to brief you, these are the syllabus aspects. Okay, now who can opt geography as an optional subject? Now this is very important question. Many students may have felt this before opting any optional subject. The main aspect that student look into is whether he has or whether she has interest in that subject. अब interest की जब बात आती है तो कैसे हमें समझेगा कि आपको geography में interest है? Let me give you an interesting example. समझो बाहर बारिश हो रहा है, it is raining outside. Then there are different type of people looking at this, let's say, situation. Like some people, some student may see outside the window and they may feel like writing a poem or listening to good music. Like they will feel good only about it. And the geography student is different from it. The geography student will start, let's say, thinking about kis type ka ये रेनफॉल है, राइट? वेदर इट इज साइक्लोनिक रेनफॉल, वेदर इट इज ओरोग्राफिक रेनफॉल, और वेदर इट इज लेट्स से कन्वेक्शनल रेनफॉल, ये मॉनसून में रेनफॉल हो रहा है, और वेदर इट इज वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंसेस लाइक विंटर रेनफॉल, राइट? और बहुत जोर से बारिश हो रहा है कम टाइम में, देन कैन इट कैन बी कॉल्ड एज देर कैन बी अ फ्लैश फ्लड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस रेनफॉल. अब ये फ्लड आएगा तो उसका इम्पैक्ट क्या होगा, और इम्पैक्ट होगा तो उसको कंट्रोल कैसे किया जाए, फ्लड मिटिगेशन, और डिजास्टर आएगा तो डिजास्टर मिटिगेशन कैसे होगा. ऑल दीज थिंग्स, और लेट्स से दिस इज द लाइन ऑफ थॉट ऑफ ज्योग्राफी स्टूडेंट, वो जरूर ऐसे सोचेगा, राइट? एंड देन देर आर अदर काइंड्स ऑफ पीपल, जैसे बारिश होते हुए कुछ लोग सोचते हैं कि यार गरम गरम चाय मिल जाती और पकौड़े मिल जाते तो मजा आ जाता, राइट? सो लेट्स से जोक्स अपार्ट, बट ये सारी चीजें समझने के बाद यू मे हैव अंडरस्टूड दैट ज्योग्राफी इज मोस्टली एन अप्लाइड सब्जेक्ट एंड लेस ऑफ थ्योरेटिकल. ओके, मोस्टली इट इज अप्लाइड सब्जेक्ट. व्हेन एवर यू ऑब्जर्व योर सराउंडिंग देन यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट दिस इज लेट्स से अप्लाइड सब्जेक्ट एंड लेस ऑफ द थ्योरेटिकल सब्जेक्ट. नाउ हु और विच लेट्स से स्टूडेंट्स हैविंग विच काइंड ऑफ बैकग्राउंड it is most favored by student geography as an optional subject. Let's say first I will tell that those with science background, they will find it very interesting and easy subject to understand. Now let me tell you some facts. What kind of facts? Let's say some background of geography, UPSC analysis. Like if you take the complete list of finally selected student, it is observed that almost 86% students, almost 86% student opt for humanities as their optional subject, and remaining as their engineering subject, or let's say science subjects like maths, or let's say medical science, the remaining subjects. Okay, So 86%. Now you may have understood that though maximum student which are selected from engineering background, let me tell you that about 66% students who are finally selected in UPSC examination are with engineering background, and 78% of total engineering and science background, and remaining let's say 20% are from humanities background. Okay, so you may have understood that those who are with science background, they opt mostly for humanities, and that too their favorite subject is geography. How? Again, one important fact, that is when we talk about the number of student attempt the mains examination or appear for mains examination, 20% of total students have geography of as a optional subject. 20%. Okay, now you can understand that if we look at these facts, how geography optional subject is important and mostly opted by students, and that too with science background. Now this is not the case that those with arts background, they should not opt this. Let me tell you, geography is interdisciplinary subject. It is blend of art and science. No pure art, no pure science, rather blend of art and science. Like here you will have science, physics involved, or let's say biology involved is there, chemistry is involved there. At the same time arts, or let's say humanities like social sciences, social studies are involved in geography. So those with humanities background or arts background, they will also find geography subject helpful. Okay, one more aspect, why geography is opted by those students with science background, because geography subject is logic based and scientific subject. What is logic based? Because most of the phenomenon in geography are explained with logic and science. There are mathematical models in there which are easy to understand for those students with science background. That's why they opt for geography. Okay, and let's say other things that why students opt for geography, like those students who find it very interesting to be with nature, or let's say connect with nature. जैसे होता है ना कि हम कॉलेज में बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स को ट्रेकिंग जाने की इच्छा होती है, राइट? दे गो फॉर ट्रेकिंग, दे गो फॉर आउटिंग प्लेसेस लाइक बीचेस, हिल्स, एंड दे एंजॉय, दे चेरिश दोज मोमेंट्स, राइट? व्हाई? बिकॉज़ दे द नेचर इंटरेस्ट देम, राइट? सो दोज स्टूडेंट्स विल डेफिनेटली लाइक ज्योग्राफी ऑप्शनल सब्जेक्ट. ओके, दोज स्टूडेंट्स विल डेफिनेटली लेट्स से लाइक दिस ज्योग्राफी ऑप्शनल सब्जेक्ट. At the same time, those students which have very curious mind to know what is going around in their surrounding, let's say surrounding environment, they will also like geography subject. Basically, geography as an optional subject is a very interesting applied subject, and student will find it very simple and easy to understand when they start studying it. Okay. Because there are no illogical, no irrational things involved, straightforward, logical, scientific based subject. Fine. So in this way we can understand who can opt geography optional subject. Now what kind of different things are provided in Lukman IAS program, or let's say Lukman IAS class, for this geography optional subject? Now as we have understood that geography is scientific subject, logic based subject, we need to have conceptual clarity, right? And here in Lukman IAS we generally provide or more give more focus on conceptual clarity. Second aspect, here we focus on difficult topics, we try to let's say deal with them in detail so that the student in the examination find it very easy to answer the questions based on those difficult topics, right? At the same time, geography is let's say mostly involves diagrams and maps, right? So more and more use of diagrams and maps to explain the concepts, explain the models, theories in the geography, in the classroom, it will help student to easily understand the concept, right? At the same time, to evaluate their understanding and their preparation level, at the end of every chapter, the test is conducted and the evaluation and feedback is given to student in the classroom itself, right? So such kind of classroom, let's say, guidance is given in the Lukman IAS. At the same time, let me emphasize what kind of extra things are given for the online students. For online students, the sessions, online sessions, or let's say doubt solving sessions will be arranged, weekly doubt solving sessions will be arranged with the faculty. At the same time, there is dedicated Telegram channel for geography optional subject, Lukman IAS, and let me tell you the address also here. You can join this channel, t.me Lukman IAS geography. Here we try to provide the linkages or interlinking of current affairs with the geography optional, and at the same time different kind of guidance is provided by the faculty. Also, the video lectures that are recorded here are given to students without any time lag, and the timely feedback and evaluation of test conducted in the class. The online students, they can opt for the online class and they will be happy to opt this Lukman IAS program, because here we focus on individual students and the mentoring by faculty is of a very high standard. So for further information on Lukman IAS geography batches and test series, you can contact Lukman IAS. Thank you.